The creature you heard, what does it say now?
It's not always like that. Some animals are just... I feel what they're feeling, you know? And whatever this thing is, it's in a lot of pain.
I see.
Why do you ask?
I am curious.
Really?
I am capable of curiosity.
Okay. Okay. this interested before. Can I talk to animals or enchanted rings or whatever?
Much has changed for both of us.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to figure out why you'd help some random animal.
Is this not what you want?
No, no, it is. I'm just surprised it's what you want, too. To kill a bunch of dark elves to get there.
I remember a young lad whom, until this very moment, would take on an army of Draugr to save a wounded animal.
But these aren't undead Draugr. They're elves. I just want to make sure we're not repeating the same mistakes. Getting involved where we shouldn't.
Oh!
Look there. That bomb should help us out. Feel like no matter what we do in Alfheim, we wind up hurting Dark Elves.
We are down here to help the creature you hurt.
I know that, but I'm usually the one who drags us around trying to rescue animals. Why do you care so much? Is there something you're not telling me?
No.
Okay.
Oh!
Gefjun's ghost! That's the largest bloody half-goof I've ever laid eyes on!
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the Song of the Sands. They don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, Lunge. We'll get you out.
What is that name?
Well, the last good thingy we saw was Diener, so...
Oh boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that little brother is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, we can't all be winners. Can't get out.
Much of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
Why did they trap it down here?
Half-goofers are known to burrow, so I hesitate to place full blame on our dark elf friends.
But but it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the Dark Elves, any more than the light belongs to the Light Elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources. One the Elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the Light Elves seem keen to banish the Hive over on their side, the Dark Elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this Hive, are we hurting Dark Elves?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No.
Then let us free it.
This is the spot! We can cut the half goofa loose here! It flies?
Of course it flies! It's a half goofa!
Sounds much happier now! And hey, the storm's gone!
Aye! Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered? He just wants to spend time with you, lad. While he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead. But if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I. Is it?
Yeah, my jawline. See? It's growing.
Is it?
That's not just dirt.
It's not dirt. Something I'm not sure I quite understand. In the Ragnarok prophecy, Odin knows, all the realms get destroyed, including Asgard. In the version Groa kept secret, Asgard still falls. Wouldn't Odin have tried to prevent it either way? What difference did her lie really make?
Wait. Let us look this way.
Looks like a lot of the sand is cleared up, but there's another storm out that way. You think that means...
Another Hafgufa! Atreus, I've been considering your question about whether Groa's deception made a difference. I think of it this way. When it comes to subverting prophecy, knowledge is power. Without the full picture and context, the finer details can lead you to tragically incorrect interpretations.
Old. We will finish later.
Ugh!
new socks.
What has happened?
They're wet.
They will dry.
You know, I just knew you were gonna say that.
Then why did you ask?
I'm really not sure.
They will dry.
Yeah, I'm sure they will.
More bloody drop.
Reminds me of tales of a cruel empress, one too angry to die.
We will see.
Now, if I recall, we were discussing how manipulating the details of a prophecy can wreak havoc on the believers. Back in my homeland, I was privy to the operations of a certain coven of heat witches who are keen on destabilizing the government.
Let this wait. Stay alert.
Sort of a harp. I can play beautifully, you know.
I do not, and would prefer it remain that way.
My travels, I heard of a great battle in your homeland, at a place called the Gates of Fire.
The Hard Gates.
You were there?
No.
Is that regret in your voice?
I did regret not dying there for many years, but no longer.
Go!